But this morning, I have hope. There's a ton of hope in this passage. And the hope is this. The hope is that whatever, or even if, whatever you've been through, whatever your relationships look like, whatever relational junk you've had to endure, whatever, even if you've gone through some really difficult, painful stuff, even if it's attacked your sense of trust in other people, even if you've had a fantastic family life and fantastic relationships your entire life, no matter what, you can have a more secure sense of identity and a greater understanding of your actual value and worth through having one relationship made right. And spoiler alert, guess what relationship that is? And everybody in church was like, I wonder what he's going to say. Is it the UPS guy? I think it's the UPS guy. He brings me really great packages all the time. Maybe it's a mailman. A mailman brings me a little bit of junk, but every once in a while he comes through. Maybe it's a mailman. I don't know what's the one relationship that can give me a greater sense of value, and it's God. Spoiler, you didn't see it coming. But I don't want us to take that as just some kind of Sunday school answer, because it's not just something that we acknowledge intellectually. Or even, if you're into this stuff, it's not something that we just learn theologically. You see, so many Christians, they walk around understanding who God is and understanding the message of His love for us as demonstrated through the cross, but they don't carry around the identity every day. They don't have a value that is secure and that trumps all of the other relational stuff that we have to go through. And I want us to get this, not just the head knowledge of what this passage we're going to look at teaches us about our value. I want us to be able to experience it so that we can be people who are so secure in our understanding of our value and identity in and through Christ, that even when the relationships blow up, even when you're having a bad week with your spouse, or a bad month, or a bad year, or bad 5 years, no matter what your circumstances look like, your sense of identity, your sense of value is locked in. And it can't be stolen by circumstance. Wouldn't that be great?